Hi guys, my name is Nick. Welcome to this episode of Connect. We're gonna go through a really exciting demo today. We have Matt Calvo, who's part of our applications team. And there's actually a lot going on in this demo with SimpleLink technology, including Wi-Fi, BLE, and Sub-1 GHz 15.4. Thanks for joining us, Matt.
No problem, good to be here.
Yeah, so this is going to be a sensor to cloud based demo. Can you tell us a little bit about what sensor to cloud means, what that solution is?
Yeah, no problem. Sensor to cloud is a TI design that the low power RF team made here at TI to help companies, startup companies, or even hobbyists get hit the ground running with a IoT connected system, basically.
Okay.
We have software that's published on TI.com for this sensor to cloud TI design, and people can download it, buy the launch pads, and get the sensor cloud demo up and running pretty fast.
Okay, so you have the sensors and the gateway to the cloud. These sensors could be any variety of things, temperature, humidity, et cetera. Can you tell us some typical applications that we could see the sensor to cloud solution used in?
Yeah, so this TI design can be expanded upon for any sort of sensor that a customer wants to use it for. Currently, we have sensors for GPS node, a Bluetooth-enabled node, and a temperature sensor node, but using the GPIOs and any sensor that communicates over SPI or UART or I2C can be used to communicate through the device and send that sensor's data over sub-1 gigahertz to the collector.
Cool. So general could be used for building automation, home automation systems, grid, all kinds of things.
Whatever your heart desires.
And all of this runs on SimpleLink hardware and the SimpleLink SDK.
Yes.
Great. So let's dive in. Can you show us at a high level kind of what we're looking at here?
Yep. So we could start at the collector up here. So this is the gateway. The gateway consists of the CC3220
and that's a SimpleLink Wi-Fi
yes
device.
This enables Wi-Fi connection, and then stacked up on top of it is the CC1352. And this provides the sub-1 gigahertz communication. And then this stack up connects to the sensors over sub-1 gigahertz. So here we also have the CC1352 as a temp sensor. And that's just reading the onboard temperature of the device.
Okay.
Here we have the Bluetooth enabled device. So it's using the CC1352 as well. And it's running the dynamic multi-protocol manager software stack released on the new SDK. And it basically allows our 1352 to run the BLE stack and the 15.4 stack concurrently. So that's what gives us the sub-1 gigahertz communication and the Bluetooth commissioning of the phone.
Okay, so it's a single radio, but it's running multiple protocols.
Exactly. So we'll do BLE and 15.4. stack. And then this last one here is also the CC1352. And this is the GPS sensor. So you can use any GPS module that adheres to the NMEA protocol, and it just communicates to the sensor through UART.
Okay.
So it's pretty modular. Just write GPS here.
All right.
So like I mentioned before, all of these communicate to the collector.
And that's in a star network.
In a star network topology. So each sensor has one connection to the collector.
And that's using, for the sub 1 gigahertz, that's using the 15.4 stack that's part of the SimpleLink SDK.
Yes. So the sensor to cloud demo out of box has the 15.4 stack running in beacon mode, actually. And this demo that we're showing here today is a little modification of it that I did that shows that added GPS functionality, the DMM, BLE, and 15.4 stack functionality, and I also modified it for frequency hopping.
Okay.
So it's hopping on 4 channels right now.
Great.
Yep. And then the gateway then uses the 3220 to connect to the internet. So we have a little wireless card over here that acts as an access point to the internet.
Okay. All right. And then I guess for the phone, that
we're
going to see some BLE interaction.
Yes, and I can draw it if you want. But yeah, we can have a Bluetooth commission with the phone for this sensor right here.
Perfect. Yeah, let's get into it. Show us what it can do and kind of talk us through it as you're going.
No problem. So we'll just start with the GPS sensor here. So we're going to give this launch pad power. If we can turn this over.
And so it's going to have to power on, connect to the collector,
network. Just powered on. It's set up to auto connect, so after a little bit we will see the red LED turn on and the sensor will populate on the 15.4 stack IoT gateway dashboard.
Okay.
So let's give it a little bit to connect to the collector.
Yeah, and so in a network like this, what's a kind of typical connect time, or is there a wide range?
It kind of depends. So we can see it already connected. It's a function of the noise around you, the amount of channels you're hopping on.
Gotcha.
If you're in frequency hopping, beacon mode, non-beacon mode. So as you can see just now, it connected in about 8 seconds or so.
Gotcha.
But that can be improved or lengthened depending on your circumstance.
Sure.
So we've got information here on the dashboard. It's got the GPS node and a little picture showing that it's a GPS sensor. We've got coordinates getting printed out in degree decimal minute format. And then we've got the RSSI, the received signal strength indicator of the sensor.
Great.
So we'll go ahead and connect the BLE sensor now. And I already know for a fact this one, to connect to the network, you have to press this button 2 on the launch pad here.
Okay.
And then we'll give it a second to connect.
Sure. And so for this node, we're going to see both the 15.4 data coming through to the collector and then onto the dashboard,
mm-hmm.
and interaction with the phone because of that dynamic multi-protocol manager doing both 15.4 and BLE.
Exactly.
Cool.
Exactly.
That's very cool.
And that's all handled by the TIR TOS.
Great.
That schedules the BLE stack and the 15.4 stack appropriately.
Gotcha.
So it looks like that connected, and we see it with the short address of 2 over here on the dashboard here. So we can actually show the Bluetooth functionality. I guess I can just go ahead and leave the phone here. And we'll go over to any BLE scanner app would work. There's options for iOS and the Android stores. So we'll go back, give it a refresh. And to make things easier, you can do this as well. I filtered using a RSSI of better than 100, negative 100, and then I'm also filtering using a DMM text so that
you just don't pick up every BLE.
Yeah, because there's so many things beaconing in that frequency range.
Gotcha.
So I'm gonna go ahead and connect to it. Mine automatically connects, but if you are a new user setting this up, you would have to use the default passcode that our BLE stack has, which is 123456.
Gotcha. Very secure.
So you go down to custom service, and we'll go ahead and do a write to the LED register. And so since it's on, we'll go ahead and write hex 0, and it should turn off. So we just saw
turn
that red LED turn off, and then we'll go ahead and turn it back on using hex 1.
And while we're able to toggle that LED from the phone, it's also sending sub-gig packets over the 15.4
network.
Yes,
at the same time, we're getting onboard temperature sensor readings from the integrated circuit, and we're also getting the RSSI of that launch pad as well.
Great.
All right, so we're gonna go ahead and connect the last sensor we have here, the temperature sensor, which is just running the 15.4 stack. So we'll give that some power and let that connect. So we should see the last launch pad populate in this dashboard with a short address of 3 when it does. And once all these sensors connect, we'll show you some features on the dashboard as well.
Great. Yeah, and this guy is aggregating the data from all 3 of these guys, acting as the collector in the network, and then passing that along to the cloud. Now, if they wanted to, with our SimpleLink SDK, there's different cloud partners and cloud plugins that they could use on the cloud side of things.
Yes, sensor to cloud is supported. It supports AWS and IBM cloud services.
But it's configurable, I think, to add a different cloud vendor if you want to work on the cloud side yourself.
Yep.
Cool.
All right, so it looks like our third sensor populated on the dashboard here, and we can see the temperature reading of that third launch pad and its associated RSSI. So now we can do some cool functionality on the dashboard here. So if you use this toggle all LEDs button, it'll send that command and do a frequency hopping broadcast command to turn off all the red LEDs of the launch pad here. So we'll click it, give it 1 second, and all the red LEDs should turn off.
Okay, so the collector basically broadcasts every node in the network.
Yep, exactly. And the little bit of latency is just due to the frequency hopping functionality. Another thing we have is this open GPS map button. So I'm logging some position, I'm logging the location of the GPS sensor over the course of about a minute. So if I open this tab here, we can see by zooming in that the location is right here at the TI headquarters.
Great. Yeah, so if we, you know, sent somebody running around with this thing, you'd see that dot moving around the map.
Yep, and anything within the sub-1 gigahertz range, we would definitely be able to pick up their location.
Very cool.
And that range could also be improved if you use a power amplifier.
Okay, and so we have a device with an integrated power amplifier that gives you a little more range if you want to extend the...
Yeah, so if you use the CC1352P for the sensors and the coprocessor, it'll boost your range by a significant amount.
Gotcha. Well, thanks, Matt. I really appreciate you showing us this. This is one of our coolest demos, and it's it already is getting me thinking about all the cool applications us or our customers can create using this technology.
There's a lot you can do with it.
Yeah, it's very cool. And thank all of you guys for joining this episode of Connect and learning a little bit more about the sensor to cloud plus GPS. If you do want to get started, you can go to ti.com/sensor-to-cloud, and you'll find all the information you need there. If you have feedback on topics you'd like to see or demos for the show, you can tweet at us at sensor-to-cloud. And be sure to join us next week for the newest Talk with an Expert episode of Connect. And thanks again, Matt.
Yep. Take care.